Welcome to Gartex Electronics. Today we are going to learn on how to connect NPN transistor in a circuit. NPN transistor is one of the two types of bipolar junction transistors, BJT. This NPN transistor consists of two N-type semiconductor materials which are separated by a thin layer of P-type semiconductor. That means that, at the emitter we have an N semiconductor and at the collector terminal we have another N semiconductor, whereas at the base we have a P semiconductor. In this NPN transistor, the majority of charge carriers are electrons while holes are the minority charge carriers. From today you should know that, the flow of electrons from emitter to collector is controlled by the current flow in the base terminal. That means that a small amount of current at base terminal can make a large amount current to flow from emitter to collector. Nowadays, the more commonly used bipolar transistor is NPN transistor, because the mobility or movement of electrons is greater than mobility of the holes. Another important point to note is that, the emitter-based junction is forward-based while the collector-based junction is reverse-biased. If we assume for a moment that the emitter-based junction is not there, then that means that no current will flow in the collector-based junction because it is reverse-biased. But when the emitter-based junction is present, practically the current will flow in the transistor because the emitter-based junction is forward-biased. Therefore, we can conclude that the collector current depends on the emitter current. For instance, if the current at the emitter base is zero, then obviously the current at the collector base is nearly zero. In our project today, we shall start by choosing the NPN transistor we are going to use. We are going to use the 2N2222 transistor, which is basically a NPN transistor. From our previous tutorials we said that, it is always a good practice to check the datasheet of electronic components before using them. We now, 2222 in the internet. I am now downloading this 2N2222 datasheet. In this datasheet you can clearly see, the type of the transistor which is NPN silicon transistor, the pinout of the 2N2222 transistor and its electrical and thermal properties. As you can see, pin 1 is the collector, pin 2 is the base, pin 3 is the emitter. And at the base emitter, the arrow is pointing outwards, meaning that this is NPN transistor. After identifying the transistor pinout, now let's start connecting it to our circuit. To connect the transistor as a switch in a circuit, we connect the output of the device that will switch on the transistor to the base of the transistor. The emitter will connect to ground of the circuit. And the collector will connect to the load that the transistor will turn on and the supply voltage of the circuit. Let me repeat this point again, the output of the device that outputs a current will be connected to the base of the transistor. The load will be connected to the collector as well as the positive DC voltage. Finally, the emitter will connect to ground. From our circuit, even though the collector of the transistor needs positive voltage in order to operate, it will not turn on just because voltage is attached to it. This is due to the fact that the transistor acts as an open circuit when it does not receive sufficient base voltage. When a transistor acts an open circuit, no current can flow down to ground. When the switch is closed, currents flow from its output pin to the base of the transistor. This electrical current switches the transistor on, so the transistor can now power its load, which is the motor. When the motor receives current, it starts to run. Now you can try to practice connecting NPN transistors using different types of NPN transistors. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Please like, comment, share and subscribe to this channel for more video updates.